In this video, we're going to finish the Properties of Trapezoid worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. In this next section, we're going to solve for x. Each figure is a trapezoid. In number 11, we're solving for x, and we can see that mn is the median. That means that mn is equal to 1/2 the sum of the bases of the trapezoid, and the bases are the lines that are parallel to one another. So that's going to be VU and WT. So we're going to sum the lengths of VU and WT, take half of that, and that will equal our median of the trapezoid MN. MN is negative x plus 21, and that's equal to 1/2 times VU, which is 11, plus WT, which is 17. So negative x plus 21 equals 1/2 times 11 plus 17, which equals 28. So the opposite of x plus 21 equals 1/2 times 28, or 28 divided by 2, which is 14. Next, I'll subtract 21 from both sides to get that negative x, or the opposite of x, is equal to 14 minus 21, which is negative 7. Then I'll just multiply both sides by negative 1 in order to get a positive x value. Negative 1 times negative x is a positive x, and negative 7 times negative 1 is a positive 7. X equals 7 in number 11. This time my x value is in one of the bases. So my median, LK, equals 1/2 times the sum of the bases, which is YX plus ZW. LK is 29, and that is equal to 1/2 times YX, which is 23, plus ZW, which is 11X, plus 2. For my next step, I'm going to multiply both sides by 2 in order to get rid of this fraction, 1/2. And at the same time, I'm going to combine my like terms within the parentheses. So that's going to be the 23 and the 2. 2 times 29 is 58, and that's equal to 1/2 times 2, which is 1, times 23 plus 2, which will be 25, plus 11x. Subtracting 25 from both sides, I'll get that 33 is equal to 11x. My next step is to divide both sides by 11. 33 divided by 11 is 3, so 3 equals x in number 12. In number 13, EC is 20, so this diagonal is 20, and the other diagonal, FD, is 5x minus 10. Remember, for an isosceles trapezoid, an isosceles is where the bases are parallel, which makes it a trapezoid, and the sides that are not the bases are congruent. So since this is indeed an isosceles trapezoid, we know that the diagonals are congruent or equal in measure. So EC equals FD. And if EC equals FD, that means that 20 is equal 5x minus 10. Adding 10 to both sides, we'll get that 30 is equal to 5x. And when we divide both sides by 5, 30 divided by 5 is 6, and 6 is equal to 5 divided by 5, which is 1, times x, which is x. So 6 equals x in number 13. In number 14, we are given consecutive interior angles, since AD is parallel to BC. So the consecutive interior angles are supplementary. That means that A plus B equals 180. A is 11x plus 8, and B is 95. That is equal to 180. My next step, I'll combine my like terms, which is my 8 and my 95. So 11x plus 8 plus 95, which is 103, equals 180. Subtracting 103, I'll get that 11x is equal to 77. And finally, dividing by 11 will give me that x is equal to 77 divided by 11, which is 7. So 7 is my solution in number 14. Lastly, for this set of directions, number 15. Looking at number 15, we can see that we have an isosceles trapezoid. That means that angles adjacent to the same base are congruent. So angle S is congruent to angle P, and angle Q is congruent to angle R. And if angle Q is congruent to angle R, that means that R is also 28x minus 11. And S and R are consecutive interior angles, and therefore will add up to 180 degrees. So 51 plus 28x minus 11 equals 180. Combining my like terms, 51 and negative 11, 51 minus 11 is 40. So 40 plus 28x equals 180. Subtracting 40 from both sides, I'll get 28x equal to 140. And dividing by 28 will give me that x is equal to 140 divided by 28, which is 5. X equals 5 in number 15. Now, if I were solving for the measure of angle Q, I would take my value of x, which is 5, and plug it in for the x in the equation for Q, and then solve. And that's what we're going to be doing in the next three problems. Our directions are to find the length of the angle indicated for each trapezoid. So again, we're going to solve for x and then plug x in for the indicated angle. And number 16, our indicated angle is V. And V is equal to 5x plus 38. So measure of angle V equals 5x plus 38. We're given an isosceles trapezoid, so that means that angle T is congruent to angle U. So angle U is also 12x minus 28. And you can see that U and V are consecutive anterior angles and are supplementary. So U plus V will equal 180 degrees. So U, 12x minus 28, plus V, 5x plus 38, equals 180. Combining my like terms, I'll combine 12x and 5x, and I'll also combine negative 28 and positive 38. 12x plus 5x is 17x, and that will get added to negative 28 plus 38, which is positive 10, and that is equal to 180. Subtracting 10 from both sides, I'll get that 17x equals 170. And when I divide by 17, we will get that x is equal to 10. So now I'm going to take that value of x, which is 10, and plug it in for my x for the measure of angle V. So the measure of angle V equals 5 times 10 plus 38. 5 times 10 is 50 plus 38 is 88. So the measure of angle V equals 88 degrees in number 16. In number 17, I'm finding the measure of angle R. We're given that R is 8x plus 34. And we know that R and Q are supplementary. So Q, which is 6x minus 22, plus R, which is 8x plus 34, will equal 180. Combining my like terms, 6x with 8x and 22 with 34. 6x plus 8x is 14x. Negative 22 plus 34 is 12, and that is equal to 180. Subtracting 12 from both sides, my term with x will be isolated on the left, which is 14x, and that's equal to 180 minus 12, which is 168. Dividing both sides by 14, I'll get that x is equal to 168 divided by 14, which is a positive 12. So knowing that x is 12, I'm going to take that value of x and plug it in for x in the measure of angle R. 8 times x will be 8 times 12, and I'm adding 34 to that quantity. 8 times 12 is 96, and when I add 34 to that, I get 130 degrees. So R is equal to 130 degrees in number 17. And lastly in this video, number 18. I'm to find the length of the base indicated for each trapezoid. I'm finding the base VU, which VU is 6x minus 6. We know that the median is equal to half the sum of the bases. FG is our median, and that's equal to half of the sum of the bases, which is TW and VU. So FG is 7x minus 4, and that's equal to 1 half times TW, which is 38, plus VU, which is 6x minus 6. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 2 at the start, so that as opposed to distributing this fraction of 1 half, I'll be distributing this whole number 2 on the left. And I will also combine my like terms within my parentheses on my right. So 2 times 7x is 14x, and we're subtracting 2 times 4, which is 8. That's equal to 38 minus 6, which is 32, plus 6x. I'll subtract 6x from both sides to get that 8x minus 8 equals 32. Then when I add 8 to both sides, I'll get that 8x equals a positive 40. And I know that 8 goes into 40 evenly, so x is going to equal 5. Knowing that x is 5, I'm going to take that value of 5 and plug it in for my x in my equation for base VU. So 6 times x is 6 times 5, and then we're subtracting 6. 6 times 5 is 30, minus 6 is 24. So in number 18, VU equals 24. And with that, we finish the properties of trapezoid worksheet. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video if you haven't done so already. Each like and subscription let me know that you're finding these videos useful and encourage me to come out with more videos for you. So do that if you haven't already. Also, if you have any questions or need further clarification on any of the problems that we've went over in this video, just leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.